How do I go back to using a local account if my machine has been set up with a Microsoft account? Hi everyone, Leo Naltenboom here for askleo.com. Microsoft really, really wants us to be using Microsoft accounts when we set up our machines so that when we log in, it's our Microsoft account we're using. On the other hand, local accounts have their place too. Microsoft has been making it more difficult to set up a machine with only a local account, but that doesn't mean you can't still use them. I've got two approaches. One, for all of its steps, is the easy way. And the other one, even though it is extremely simple, is the hard way. Let's have a look. So here I am in my Windows 11 home machine. I'm going to go ahead and fire up settings so that we can indeed check that, in fact, I'm signed in with a Microsoft account. We'll go here to accounts. And there it is. It's my AskLeo example at hotmail.com account. It's a Microsoft account. What if I don't want to use that? The easy way, although it is multiple steps, is to create an additional user account that is a local account. So I scroll down in this window until I find other users. I'll click on that. We'll add an account. I don't have an email address and I don't have a phone number. I want this to be a local account. So I don't have. Add a user without a Microsoft account finally shows up. I'll click on that. Now we'll create a traditional local user account. Unfortunately, with local accounts, Microsoft insists that you fill in three secret questions. I'm going to skip ahead after I fill these in, but this is a requirement and it's unfortunate, but it really is the only account recovery mechanism you have available for local accounts. So please make sure to fill these out with something that makes sense to you. And there it is. We have a local account on the machine. Now, if it is the account that you want to start using, there's one other change I might recommend. I'm clicking on it and I'm going to change the account type. I'm going to change it to be an administrator. Now remember, an administrator account is really just an administrator capable account. All it really means is that when you see a UAC dialog, all you need to do is click on OK. The existing account that this machine was created with, the Microsoft account, it is already an administrator account. So if you're going to swap one for the other, this would be the way to make sure that this new account is the account you expect. And that's it. Seriously, that's it. However, now that we've got our local account set up, we can't, if we want to, sign in as that user account. See, it's now another option on the login page, and we'll sign in with that. Now, you can continue to use this local account. My recommendation is, in fact, that you do exactly this. You leave the Microsoft account alone. You stop using it. You instead use this new local account for whatever it is you want to use it for. Yes, that does mean you'll need to transfer some data. Depending on how far you have set things up or how long you've been using it with the Microsoft account. Unfortunately, it also means that you'll need to reinstall some applications. Not all of the applications you installed while you were within the Microsoft account will be accessible to this new local account. Some of them will give you the option to install for all users, and that's great. Those should be available. The others may not. And those, like I said, you'll simply have to reinstall while you are signed in as this user. But that's what it boils down to. All we've really done is created an additional account on the machine, a local user account, made sure that it is administrator capable, and simply switched to using that alone. Now, there is another option. I call this the simple but painful approach. and that is to reinstall Windows 11 from scratch using some of the workarounds that are available to create Windows 11's installation with only a local user account. Those techniques are often thwarted by Microsoft. Like I said, they really don't want you to use only a local account on your machine. But if they work, those are really the only way that I know of to set up the operating system from the beginning with no Microsoft account at all. That's why, in the long run, my recommendation is that if you want to be running a local user account, simply make it an additional account on the existing machine without getting rid of the Microsoft account and switch to using it for your day-to-day. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/172754. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.